You are welcome to the broadcast of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International. In this broadcast, join International Crusade and Conference Speaker, Teacher, Senior Pastor, Apostle, General Overseer and Presiding Prelate of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International, Bishop Akintayo Samjoli.
I announce to you, whatever was to follow you, that is not from God, it will not follow you, it will not follow your children.
His teachings and ministries have brought deliverance and transformation to many lives and families across the nation and beyond. Receive God's word with faith in your heart and watch your life move from glory to glory.
Hallelujah. You're welcome to another morning in the presence of God, and I want to encourage you to look out for someone who is not connected this morning and help them get into the blessings of God and what he has for us this morning. Remember, if you're on YouTube and if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do so. If you're on Facebook and you've not yet commented or shared, remember to do so. Like and do something that will help someone else be connected and to receive what God has for us this morning. We continue to have more understanding in the Word of God as concerns fasting. And I want to briefly deal with a little aspect of a very wide subject in the Word of God. And I want to look at the power of individual and personal fasting. We do fasting in three categories: an individual fast, a corporate fast, a national fast. Today, I want to look at individual, personal, and corporate fasting. But once again, I want to charge you to call someone and encourage someone to be connected this morning. Make it a personal move to obediently call someone and tell them and encourage them, get on this morning. Let somebody else hear through you encouragement. Let somebody else be blessed through your personal and direct encouragement. Now, we have looked at the different types of fasting, but let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 4 and we read verse 1 and verse 2. We're looking at the power of the individual and personal fasting. Let's go to Matthew chapter 4. It says, "Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward and hungered." Now, the Lord Jesus was led by the Spirit of God into a time of personal fasting. Now, you need to understand that the times, it is not the Spirit of God that will lead you. You are the one that should go into a personal time of fasting according to what you see and what you have been taught by the Word. One of the things that the prophet Samuel told Saul, who became king, was that you'll do as the occasion serves you. You may not be told everything. The Holy Spirit will give you wisdom and insight, and you do what is appropriate. Now, why did the Lord, the Holy Spirit, lead the Lord Jesus Christ into fasting? Now, the Holy Spirit knew who Jesus was and who he is. If we do not know, if nobody knows, the Holy Spirit knows. He searches the hearts. He knows even the depth of what goes on within you. The devils know that Jesus Christ is Lord. So the Holy Spirit knew that the devil cannot know and the Holy Spirit doesn't know. He knows that Jesus Christ is Lord. But he knew that so long as the Lord Jesus Christ was upon the face of the earth, he knew that he had to respond to situations according to the territory in which he found himself. You've got to respond in accordance. Saul told Samuel, he says, do as the occasion serves you. I will not be there to give you every instruction. I will not be there to tell you everything that you're supposed to do. Look at what is going on and be able to determine what your action should be and would be. But the Holy Spirit would lead us also and help us. He knew what the Lord Jesus Christ would have to face upon the face of the earth. And he knew that even though this is the Word incarnate, the Word became flesh. According to John 1 verse 14, the Word, as powerful as it is, also is made more potent, more fruitful when we surround it with fasting and prayer. It is made more impactful. It has more impact when we now surround it with prayer and fasting. And there's some things you can address corporately, but there's some growth in your life that only take place when you personally rise to deal with the situation. No matter how you have a praying church, no matter how you have a praying father, a praying mother, a praying pastor, a praying wife, a praying husband, an anointed servant of God as your husband. In fact, when you have those ones around you, it's probably the reason why you should pray some more. Because you must understand that they are high targets of the enemy. They are prime targets. If your husband is a man of God, you must understand that his life and his family, they are prime target. If your wife is a woman of God, you know, if your husband is a great general in an army, don't just sit down enjoying all the sweets of office. You move here, everybody salutes you, and whatever, and my husband is this. You must understand that your house is a high target. You must understand there are missiles from a distance that can be sent against your house. You enjoy yourself, first lady. My husband is president. You must understand that they don't sit down planning assassination and coups against someone in some corner somewhere. Your husband is a prime target. So you do not sit down and you say, the people around me, they are people of prayer. It should rather let you know that because my son is this man of God, my daughter is this, my parent is this, therefore I am a target. Listen, the enemy does not have the same victory he has when he causes the son of a member somewhere to go astray and to fall into sin as when he causes the son of a servant of God to go into error. No, the victories are not the same. To beat some unknown boxer is different from beating some Floyd Mayweather. It's a different story. So you must understand that the more you go close and serving God, the more your life is a target. And when there's an assignment upon your life, you need to fast and pray. The level of attacks against you is different from the attacks against somebody else who's around in some corner somewhere. So you have got to realize that the Holy Spirit knows why he led the Lord Jesus Christ to fast and to pray. He knew also the victories that this would bring into the life of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Luke 4 verse 14, the Bible says, and Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out a fame of him throughout all the region round about. Christ returned in the power of the Spirit. He increased the level of power working in his life by going into prayer and fasting. So you must understand that as you are, you need to increase the level of power at work in your life and around you. You need to take it to a different level. You need to enter into a higher dimension of anointing, into a higher dimension of victory. And this comes by prayer and fasting. He had received the Holy Spirit upon his life when he was baptized in Jordan, and the heavens opened and the Spirit of God came upon him, and John saw it and testified. The Spirit of God came upon him like a dove. It was clear, but he needed more than that anointing, and so he needed to continue. You must understand that you've got things to do, and you need power to do what you've got to do. So you must understand there's need for you to fast and pray, one, because of the level of attacks you're dealing with, the level of wickedness that surrounds your life. So you need to seek God in fasting and prayer. All right? The level of battles that you face warrants you to seek God in prayer. Okay? Number two, the magnitude of the work you face requires your fasting. You need to seek God in prayer and fasting because of the work ahead of you. You need to seek God in fasting and prayer because of the opposition that is coming against you and that's been raised against you. You need to seek God in prayer and fasting because of that. You need to seek God in prayer and fasting because you need to be fruitful. There's a need for fruitfulness. None of these things that I've mentioned would work well in your life, in our lives, if we cannot engage in prayer and fasting. Battles come against us. Temptations come against us. Christ told his disciples, you need to pray. You need to fast and pray. You need to seek God in prayer. And he taught them importance. Now, there are blessings that you need and that have been blocked in the realms of the Spirit. So you realize that in the case of Daniel, the blessings that he needed was blocked in the realms of the Spirit. And so he had to engage in prayer and fasting. And so you have to engage in prayer and fasting also because of the blessings that have been blocked in the realms of the Spirit. When you engage in prayer and fasting, you can open up the heavens for blessings to come down and rest on you. So you need to fast and pray. It's not just, the church is fasting, the bishop is fasting, this person is fasting. You also need to engage in prayer and fasting because there's so many things, so many blessings that you need to release through prayer and fasting. They can only come through. They can only come through. You find out that deliverance from trouble is a blessing from God. Peter was in jail and they were anointed of God. But because of the absence of appropriate prayer and fasting, James was killed. And so now that Peter was there, was arrested, they realized that there is going to be the same outcome if we do not engage in prayer and fasting. Yes, you read it and say that they made prayers. So you might not see fasting written there. But you must understand that the early church knew the importance of combining fasting with their prayers. So please understand the importance of combining fasting with your prayer. Understand the importance of calling upon God. Understand the importance of seeking God and seeking God as an individual. One of the power of corporate prayers is that there are individuals fasting going on as well. So it's a combination. When we fast as a body, what makes it powerful is the individuals are also fasting. And that comes in and brings the corporate power, the corporate force, the corporate dimension. So you realize that one of the importance of you fasting as well is to add to the corporate strength, add to the corporate power of the body. There are some people, they add nothing. They are constantly a burden to and wait to whatever prayer effort is going on in the ministry. Because while the church is praying, they are living as Achan, constantly sinning, constantly walking in the flesh, constantly doing something else. So there's no adding to the corporate strength of fasting and prayer. You need to fast and pray so you can add to the strength of the body. Now let's look at the account of Cornelius. Let's read Acts 10, verse 1 to verse 6. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band, a devout man and one that feared God with all his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision, evidently, about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, what is it, Lord? And they said unto him. Now, please, read with me now. And he said unto him. I need to read out loud, read audibly with me. Okay, follow me. And he said unto him, the prayer of your neighbor's prayer, the congregation's prayer. No, he said your prayer and your alms are come up for memorial before God. Your prayer has come up before God. Amen. In verse 2, the Bible says, a devout man of faith, God gave much alms and prayed to God all way. Now, but there's some an information that is missing in this passage. So go to verse 30 and see the information that Cornelius added. Let's read verse 30 together. Everybody read out. And Cornelius said, 4 days ago, I was fasting until this hour. And at the ninth hour, I prayed in my house. So listen. So when you read and say that, yes, Cornelius prayed and gave, you can just keep the fact that he did not just pray. He did not just give. You see, the Bible says all things work together for good. All things. So it's not just one thing. I did this one thing. You know, I did that one thing. I gave a seed. I'm a big giver. What about your prayer? Are you a man or woman of prayer? Are you a man or woman who seeks God in fasting? Cornelius says, I was in prayer. It's not a matter he was boasting and giving from. No. He was explaining that this is what happened. Now, because of the prayer and fasting of Cornelius, and there were angelic powers released. The prayer of one man released angelic activities. So you find out that your prayer and fasting as an individual can release spiritual activities that will favor you, that will favor your life. But now you find out that the prayer and fasting of Cornelius, you see, here's another reason why you fast and pray. Because the destiny of others hangs upon your life. As you are here, You have no idea what you represent. At the time that Cornelius was fasting and praying, he never understood. He never knew that he was a door to the Gentile world. That through his family, through him, his family and other Gentiles will receive the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. He never knew that he was chosen to be a door. Or rather, that his fasting and prayer will cause him to be that door. You have got to engage yourself in prayer and fasting, because there are great things that can come through your life. You must understand that Peter had been fasting and praying. John had been fasting and praying. Matthew, all these people were fasting and praying. But you realize that some breakthrough did not happen until Cornelius fasted and prayed. It was his fasting and prayer that released a vision to Peter. It was his fasting and prayer that caused God to show Peter, don't call anything that I've cleansed common. Had showed him a vision that changed the understanding of the Jews. That he saw a bedspread coming down from heaven, a sheet or something, filled with unclean things that the Jews never ate before. And he told him, guys, kill and eat. He said, no. I mean, Lord, you know me now. I'm a true Jew. I've never done that before. I've never. And he said, hey, Peter, what I've cleansed, the ones you're talking about are the ones that are around you upon the face of the earth. Can't you see that this is coming from heaven, from me? Whatever I have cleansed, do not call common. The understanding of Peter was changed because of the fasting of Cornelius. Because of the fasting of one Gentile. The man was not even saved. He was not a born-again Christian yet. He feared God. It was out of his fasting and prayer. The visitation came that brought him salvation and brought salvation to his household and brought the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Later on, Peter had to go and answer questioning from the Jewish brethren. You, Peter, you did not do this. How come you went to the Gentiles? How come you couldn't baptize the Holy Spirit? I say, hey, hold on. My own part, I was praying. I was preaching. I was not even praying. And I responded to a vision. It was one man that did this, so it's not me. And when he did this, God had to come down and show me vision. And as I was busy speaking, it was him. I didn't ask. Now we see the Holy Spirit. I didn't ask from them. While I was still preaching, the Holy Ghost fell on them. It is that man, Cornelius. He opened something in scripture that our eyes had not seen, that we are not yet understood about the salvation of the Gentiles. It is that man, Cornelius. It is his fasting and prayer that brought to pass the things that we are seeing. What can I one day look at as a minister and point to you and say, it is that brother that prayed? What can I look back and say when people are testifying? What can I step up and say, hold on. You see that crusade? You see those churches planted in that place? Do you see those thousands that are saved there? Do you see this dimension of international ministry? It was Emil. It was that pastor. It was that brother. This was not even a pastor. He was not even a shepherd. He was not even a covenant family leader. It was one guy out there, one soldier, one centurion who was supposed to be oppressing the Jews. His eyes got saved. I mean, opened. That, hey, there's a God, and I need this God. And began to fast and pray. Today, I challenge you. In the midst of everyone else that's supposed to fast and pray, do not wait and do not be, you know, discouraged by others not praying and fasting. When you're fasting and they're eating, do not stop to eat. The entire house of Cornelius, they were eating and drinking. Jews also were eating and drinking. Cornelius engaged in fasting and prayer. Today, are you going to see God in fasting and prayer? This month, are you going to do that? Are you going to change the year ahead? Are you going to change things in this entire nation? and in the nations of the world. My God, Cornelius did not just affect the Italians, he affected the entire globe. One man, a devout man. That means he didn't pray one day and forget the next day and say, I slept off. He didn't pray and just say, my battery finished, I ran out of charge, I was online. No, he would make sure everything was in place and then seek God. This morning, I challenge you to seek God in fasting and prayer. Do not wait for someone else. Do not look onto someone else who may never respond to the need. Who may never. There was a man that was attacked by robbers. People passed by. The Levite passed by. The priest passed by. Did not respond. It was a Samaritan, somebody outside of the faith of the Jews, that responded. Are you going to respond to the call? Paul says at one point, he said, no man stood with me among all the believers. It is only this household that stood with me. Are you going to be that person that will respond? Are you going to be that person that will respond? Stand to your feet, everybody. And this morning, ask God for one thing. Ask God for grace to respond in prayer. Ask God to respond. Ask God to have grace to stand when others cannot stand, when others cannot pray, when others could not serve. There's a time Paul said, it is only Epaphroditus. That is a man, he even became sick, nigh unto death, and God had mercy on him and on me. Because among all the workers, for some reason, even Timothy at that point had not responded. It was Epaphroditus that responded. May you be the person that will respond.
Amen.
The person that will go through.
Amen.
The person that will say, I am going through in fasting to the end.
Yes, sir.
I have got this opposition. I've got these challenges. But I'm going to go through.
Amen.
In fasting unto the end. Never forget these reasons. Fast because of the level of battle you face. Fast because of the magnitude of work ahead of you. Fast because of the position that comes against you. Fast because you want to be fruitful.
Yes, sir.
Fast so you can overcome temptation.
Amen.
Fast because there are blessings that must come through.
Amen.
Fast because the destinies of others rely upon you. Fast because you are adding to corporate strength. Fast because you are releasing spiritual activities.
Amen.
Fast because you are a door.
Yes, sir.
Begin to pray right now.
Rapa shaka papa 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 papa. Zekete.
Ask God to prevail.
Man,
against every battle that has come against your life.
Rapata zaklata.
Pray right now, say, God, make me capable
Makaske
to face every battle.
Arima.
Lord, make me capable. Social battle, spiritual battle.
Brokoto, from various angles. Atuze.
Pray right
rapa,
now.
Pa, 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 pa,
Lord,
pa, pa.
I ask for grace.
Mandus.
For the rapata,
zakata, brakata. Iatete, rikakata, brandus. Mandus ete zekete reandus arima rapata zakata brakata makus zekle ete brandus
mandus
iatete rikakata makarima rigata arima
mandus
zekle zekete robokoto brokoto
rapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapapap
blessings that can only come through
because
of the prayer and fasting.
Pray right now. Zakata brakata
release
blessings that inherit
that you not fail to do the destiny of others. Come and talk to God right now.
Zakata
makose blabada da da da
te prekate zekate makuse ayande riatata brakataske makarima riga tarima tata arima rokoto rokoto rakapapa Zakata mandus brandus zemandus brekatus brekataske rapakata zakata riande zemande sekate brekate
man, those spiritual activities,
the prayer
Amen.
Now coming to the into God's hands. Ask the Lord to go before you.
Yes, sir.
Ask him for his blessings to be showered upon your life.
Amen.
Pray right now. Lift up your hands and pray.
Amen.
Lift up your offerings unto God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, Father.
Father.
I thank you for your word.
I thank you for your word.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
I pray that you receive.
I pray that you receive.
My sacrifice this morning.
My sacrifice this morning.
Let my seed speak on my behalf.
Let my seed speak on my behalf.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Favor me in a special way.
Favor me in a special way.
As you go through this time.
As you go through this time.
Of fasting, O God.
Of fasting, O God.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Open great blessings.
Open great blessings.
Upon my life.
Upon my life.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, my Father.
Thank you, my Father.
In Jesus' name we pray. Do not miss the devotional service tomorrow morning. Do not miss the Thursday services. Share the word. Prepare yourself. And be like Elijah when others are eating and drinking. Be like Cornelius. And when others are doing what they're doing, seek God in prayer and fasting. Elijah would even send, go tell the king, you can go. Let him go eat and drink. And he went to seek God in fasting and prayer. Do not be like those who tell others to go and fast and they go eat and drink. Unfortunately, that's what others do. I mean, if there's a health challenge, I've taught you how to handle that. If it's such that, yes, you cannot fast, yes, I can understand. But don't send others to go fast and pray and you go to eat and drink. If you need to fast part of the day, do it. If you need to fast eating some kind of stuff, do it. But engage in prayer and fasting and let God come through for you. Well, it's a blessing listening to you once again, serving God and serving his people. I am Bishop Akintel Samjali, and I'm ministering to you live from the altar of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International. I'm praying for you, and I trust that you also, I hope you're praying for me. God bless you until we'll see you again. Let's share the grace of our Lord, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Rest, remain, and abide with us all. Now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you.
I believe you've been tremendously blessed by this program with such powerful exposition of God's Word. Join the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International in our next broadcast. Also join us in worship at the Faith Cathedral 5 and 7 Victoria Street in Freetown on Sundays at 7 and 9 a.m. and Thursdays at 6 p.m. For prayers, counseling and testimony, please call +232 30 90 007 or +232 77 853 2207 or +232 7785 8151. This is the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International.